Dante wants to build a plant box. He puts rock in the bottom for drainage as pictured below. So here's the plant box. Notice how the bottom 2 inches contain the rock. At least 1/3 of the plant box must be soil. Dante has 300 cubic inches of soil. At what height should Dante fill the plant box with soil? So if we take a look at the height, unfortunately, we cannot easily divide it into thirds or divide it into 3 equal pieces because the height is 8, and therefore we'll have to solve this problem using volume. And because the plant box is a right rectangular prism, we know the volume is equal to the length times the width times the height. Let's begin by determining the total volume of the box. So in this case, the volume is going to be equal to 9 inches times 8 inches times 8 inches. So 9 times 8 times 8 is equal to 576, and therefore the volume is equal to 576 cubic inches. So for our next step, we want to find 1/3 of the volume to determine at least how much of the volume must be soil. So to find 1/3 of the volume of 576 cubic inches, we want to divide 576 by 3. So 576 divided by 3, which again will give us 1/3 of the volume of the plant box, is equal to 192, and therefore 1/3 of the volume is 192 cubic inches. So this tells us that at least 192 cubic inches of the volume must be soil. Now to determine at what height Dante should fill the plant box with soil, let's determine the volume of each inch in height. So to find the volume of each inch in height, we're going to use the same volume formula, length times width times height, but for each inch in height, of course, the height will only be 1. So the volume of each inch in height would be equal to 9 inches times 8 inches times 1 inch. Well, 9 times 8 times 1 is equal to 72, and therefore the volume of each inch of the box is equal to 72 cubic inches. So now we need to figure out how many inches in height, or how many 72 cubic inches it will take to reach at least the volume of 192. Well, we know if he adds 1 inch of soil, 1 times 72 is equal to 72 cubic inches. That's obviously not at least 192 cubic inches. If he added 2 inches of soil, 2 times 72 is equal to 144, so the volume would be 144 cubic inches. Again, not at least 192, so he must add more soil. If he adds 3 inches of soil, 3 times 72 is equal to 216 cubic inches. And now notice how if he adds 3 inches of soil into the plant box, he would be adding 216 cubic inches of soil to the plant box, which is at least 192 cubic inches of soil. And therefore, if he adds 3 inches, it would satisfy the condition of at least 1/3 of the plant box must be soil. But remember, he has 300 cubic inches of soil. So let's see if it would be okay if he added another inch of soil to the plant box. Well, if he added 4 inches of soil to the plant box, he'd be adding 4 times 72, or 288 cubic inches of soil to the box, which is still at least 192 cubic inches and less than 300. So he actually has a choice. He can add 3 inches of soil or 4 inches of soil, and it would still satisfy the condition of at least 1/3 of the plant box must be soil. But we need to be careful because the question is, at what height should Dante fill a plant box with soil? So one option would be to add 3 inches, and since 2 plus 3 is 5, he could add soil to the height of 5 inches here and satisfy the condition. But he could also add 4 inches of soil. 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, so he could also add soil up to the 6 inch mark here, and again still satisfy the condition of having at least 1/3 of the plant box be soil. So there's actually 2 correct answers for this problem. Let's go ahead and write this out. We can say Dante should fill the plant box to a height of 5 inches or 6 inches. Now for your Common Core assessment though, you would either answer 5 or 6, not both. Both would be counted as correct. I hope you found this helpful.